Hello, friends. Tom Downey here for Chat Sports. The 2019 NBA Draft, it is over. Time to hand out grades. So let's take a look at the Golden State Warriors. They entered this year's draft with picks number 28 overall and number 58 overall. However, they were openly searching for at least one more pick because they got all kinds of guys that are going to be free agents, injuries. They needed the depth there. Now, their plan was to target the best player, not necessarily just a center or just a shooting guard to help replace the injured Klay Thompson there. They were looking for best player available. In the first round, Golden State actually did a bit of a surprise. They were definitely looking for shooting, but Jordan Poole was not projected by really anyone to be a first-round selection. Then Golden State pulls the trigger on him at number 28 overall. It was a surprise. Now, he's definitely a project who was worth taking a risk on, but it was kind of viewed as more of a late risk than an early risk. A great shooter, but streaky. The highs are really high when he's on his game. He's making all kinds of plays, can shoot from deep, 37% overall there, only 12.8 points per game. But the lows are frustrating. He wasn't the go-to guy at Michigan. Again, he often takes those hero mode shots, as the Golden State Warriors have frankly had issues with over the past couple of years in terms of guys just taking off-ball shots off the dribble and not really looking all that great in the process there. Poole, though, might slot in right away at shooting guard, given that there's Klay Thompson, who's hurt, and Jacob Evans, who was an equally late first-round pick there. So Poole goes off the board, number 28 overall. I'm curious how he fits in at Golden State. They love shooting there, but this one was definitely a surprise. So how surprised were you guys? Don't lie and say you weren't. Everyone was surprised with that selection of Jordan Poole. Insert an emoji. You got some options up there. I think it's that third one there. That, like, ooh, face. That's for me, at least. I was very surprised to see Jordan Poole go off the board in that first round. I have a sneaking suspicion, by the way, that Golden State really liked Dylan Windler, and then the Cavs took him two spots before. Well, let me know in the comment section with that emojis. How surprised were you of Jordan Poole being the pick in the first round? Now, Golden State also was making deals to add extra second-round picks. The Pelicans had too many. They wanted to trade some away. So Golden State gets number 39 overall. They send our boy cash considerations, often on the move on draft night, a 2021 second-round pick, and a 2023 second-round pick. New Orleans gets those, and the Warriors get their secret, kind of, sort of, but not really hidden guy, Alen Smailagic, who played for the Santa Cruz Warriors this past year. And Golden State just kind of, like, hit him. He was playing for the Warriors, the G League Warriors. It's allowed, by the way. You can play in the G League and not be draft eligible, but your rights don't, like, go to the Warriors. So he was draft eligible this year, played for that Santa Cruz G League affiliate, a Serbian native. Golden State, there were at least accusations that they tried to hide him. They realized that they had something good in practice, and he often had some nice impact plays as a stretch four, a little bit undersized, but a stretch four type there. And oh, by the way, offers that stretch four, but he wasn't the best shooter, only 24%, but the flashes, the stroke is all there. So intriguing skills there as a developmental type four. He's still very young, still in his teens. They're going to turn 20 this year. Needs to add some extra weight. Might spend this year in the G League as well, but the Warriors wanted this guy. That was a not well-kept secret. So they get their man by trading up to get him in round two. Now, Golden State, before the draft actually started, also bought a second-round pick from the Atlanta Hawks. This one, a 2024 second-round pick. So in total, Golden State ships out three second-round picks in the future to get two this year, plus more cash considerations, and they get Eric Paschall out of Villanova, which I find is a fun fit. I like this fit quite a bit for Golden State. This one was maybe the most known name that they took. I think that's reasonable. No disrespect meant to Jordan Poole there. And also, he might be the most ready to make week or game one impact. Very more of a well-developed kid, kind of that higher floor, lower ceiling type guy. Did a little bit of everything for Villanova. 16.5 points per game, 6 rebounds. Good frame. He's a little over 6'7", has a 7-foot wingspan. Can shoot some threes a little bit. Not like a true stretch four, but offers that ability to shoot some three ball. Oh, by the way, he can play some small ball five. Who does that remind you of? a little bit like Draymond Green right now. Look, Eric Paschall's not going to be Draymond Green. That's not going to be his long-term outcome. But as a Jordan Bell type who's a pending free agent here, makes some sense for Golden State to add some more depth at that power forward spot and find some more guys that can at least help you the next couple years and give you some minutes. Not like 15 minutes, but 5 minutes a game, 10 minutes a game. That's valuable here at number 41 overall. So those were the three picks by the Golden State Warriors. So let me know in the comment section, what was your favorite selection? I like going with Smailagic. Poole was a bit of a head scratcher to me. I'm going to go with Eric Paschall. I thought that was good value for Golden State and can help maybe even before Smailagic does in terms of bringing some value off the bench at that forward position. Now the Golden State Warriors in their lineup for this season. Not what we're used to seeing. Of course, Curry's going to be your star. We'll leave Klay Thompson off this because he's hurt. Tore his ACL. Who knows when he comes back to the Golden State Warriors. Draymond, of course, is there. Giant question mark at center. Damian Jones on the roster, but Looney and Jordan Bell, and Bogut too, I guess, all free agents. So there is no obvious center fit there. Iguodala, I'll put him in there right now because, well, it's not probably going to be Kevin Durant. He's a free agent regardless either way. And then the bench, Livingston, maybe Jacob Evans can beat out Jordan Poole. Maybe there's a signee that competes there too. Alphonso McKinney, don't know if he's really an ideal guy there. But frankly, this Golden State Warriors team, very different than what we've seen the past couple of seasons. Now, Golden State did have number 58 overall as well, but they traded that pick away. Mia Oney was taken by the Utah Jazz. Golden State got back some of that cash considerations that they needed. So Golden State did not spend the number 58 overall pick. Tells me they didn't really want anybody else out there. Again, Golden State there had a chance to make 4 picks, flipped away that pick instead. Instead, they got some more cash considerations back there. And instead, they took Jordan Poole, they took Alen Smailagic, and they took Eric Paschall as well. Now the Golden State Warriors there, a C+. That's what I'm giving them one. That's what I'm giving them there. We'll get that fixed up for us. It wasn't a bad was not a bad haul by any means. Just don't know if it was the best haul. The Jordan Poole pick has a head scratcher. Now, given his highs and the way Golden State has developed players in recent years, he might become, because of his landing spot, might be more likely to reach it than if, say, like, I don't know, the Hornets took him or something. So a high risk, maybe a high reward, though, upside there for the Golden State Warriors. I gave it a C+. Jimmy gave it a C. A little bit average to above average here. They'll find some impact. They definitely like Smailagic, but we haven't seen a ton of him after he spent the G League season kind of almost hidden away with the Santa Cruz Warriors. He might stick in the G League again this coming season. I think Jordan Poole, though, because of the need at shooting guard, makes the most sense for the guy that's going to see the most playing time early on. So grade the Golden State Warriors 2019 NBA draft haul. I know you guys are going to give it like an A because that's what, you know, Golden State fans do. You just all buy into the draft class. I think it's average, though. Again, you didn't pick till 28. You're not going to get a superstar player. A, B, C, D, or F. Imagine, though, if Golden State had taken Kevin Porter Jr. That would have been a fun pick, at least as far as I'm sure. Even Keldon Johnson. I think both those guys would have been nice fits for Golden State more so than Jordan Poole. Let's make some notes now of some undrafted free agents. They did pick up Dedrick Lawson out of Kansas there. He is going to be a summer league invite only, so he can still be a G League guy, but he has not been promised a two-way contract. Another power forward guy out of Kansas. Put up good numbers, 19.4 points per game, 10.3 rebounds, but general consensus doesn't project as well to the NBA as he did at Kansas. So Golden State did have some big needs. They needed some more wing help, both shooting guard and small forward. They needed more shooting. They got that in Jordan Poole. They also focused on power forward depth as well, which I found interesting. So small forward center still remain areas of focus for the Golden State Warriors. Now it's all about, well, what do they do when it comes to free agency? Because they can't add anybody really. Now they can, you know, throw out some mid-level deal or a mid-level deal, but they have no cap space. Even if they renounce everybody, they don't have any more money available. So they're going to offer Klay Thompson a max deal and Kevin Durant. Klay Thompson's going to take it. Kevin Durant, I'm not so sure on that one. That's going to be a big focal point for Golden State. But with Thompson out, Durant out, even if he comes back, it's Steph Curry, Draymond Green, and God, what else will that roster look like after free agency is all said and done?